Let's present this episode with a story. Okay then, so, back when I was a teenager, I used to hang out with my father quite a lot. I mean, we used to go to a lot of places together. We always loved going on the trains because we used to be into trains quite a lot. And we also enjoyed just, you know, being around each other a lot. It was fun times. And one time, I decided, you know what? Right, I said to my dad, you know, we've done so many things over these past few years, but one thing we've never done is we've never gone camping. We've never ever gone camping. And he said to me, you know something, Chris? That is a great idea. Let us go camping for the weekend. We'll find a nice forest, somewhere that is legal, well, a good place to set up camp, and we'll camp out there for the weekend. We'll bring plenty of food, and we'll bring all sorts of things we can do, like you can bring your handhelds if you want. You know, we can just do all these great things while camping. So I said, okay, cool. So, a couple of weeks went by, and my father came to me. He said to me, Chris, do you remember when you asked me if you wanted to go camping? And I said, yes, I remember. Why, have you found a place? And he said, yes, it's all the way in Wales. However, the good news is it'll be during the summertime, so we won't have to worry about all the relentless drizzly rain that Wales just loves to be plagued with. So don't worry, there'll be plenty of things to be enjoyed there, and it'll be in a nice forest that is well a common location for camping. So, we packed all our stuff up. I got my, at the time, Game Boy Advance, and we also got all our train magazines, and in addition we also took all the food that we had prepared, and we set out. The con to this journey though was the place we had to drive to was about 4 hours away, and me, unfortunately, one fact you may not know about me is the fact that I actually get travel sick quite easily. So we had to prepare gallons and gallons of salt water for me to drink while we was on the way down to Wales. It didn't actually work, and we ended up having to clean the car over 5 times on the way there, but eventually we made it. You know, although I must confess, some of the sick was so bad that it actually became a part of the interior to the car, and it still exists to this very day. I think about that journey every time I look at the inside of the car. So we arrived, and we set up camp. We actually bought this wonderful, beautiful tent. It was a nice, big, dark brown tent, and it was big enough to hold like 5 people. So since there was only 2 of us, we were going to have plenty of space and plenty of room to sleep in, and it was looking to be a pretty good time. We arrived there on Friday afternoon, and we intended to stay there until around Sunday early afternoon. So roughly 2 days we spent out there camping. The weather was just so warm. It was ever so warm, we just couldn't believe how warm it actually was, especially considering where we were. So we set up all the campfire, we got the tent set up, we got all the food ready so that we could eat whenever we wanted, and everything was set up ever so perfectly. And then we just chilled. I played some Golden Sun on my Game Boy Advance, he just sat there reading a lot of his train magazines, and sometimes we would just chat away and discuss what we were going to do, because we weren't going to stay there the entire time. Like, we did plan to sometimes, you know, maybe one of us would stay there and one of us would go into the nearby town, because there was actually a town about a couple of miles away from where we were, and you know, sometimes one of us would go there just to do a bit of exploring. Obviously we couldn't leave the campsite because, well, we didn't want it to get robbed. But yeah, that's what we did sometimes. And then something interesting happened. Something very interesting. It came to Saturday night, and it was around 8 p.m. And suddenly my father said to me, Chris, you're not going to believe this. And I said, what is it? And he said, look over there. Look at what's looking at us from over there. And I was scared because I thought it was some sort of mad animal. And I was actually right about the Mad Animal because he had driven there with me. But seriously, he actually had... I was really scared and I was hesitant to turn around. But he said, don't worry, just turn around and look. And we looked, I looked, and what did we see? Three beautiful brown foxes. And these foxes were staring at us. They were really staring at us. I couldn't believe what we were seeing. Now, for those of you that may not know, you know, it's common for foxes to come out in the night time, but for the time period that we were in, 8 p.m. I think it was, or 7 p.m. I think it was 8 p.m. It was pretty rare for foxes to come out that early in the night. Sure, it was possible, granted, but you know, we had been to many places in the past, you know, and you know, and never we had seen a fox out that early in the night time. So these foxes, they were just sitting there. They were staring at us. They were just staring at us, and I thought, what on earth are they doing? Are they going to attack us, or are they just going to look at us? And about half an hour went by, and these foxes were still there. They were just sitting there. They were like cats. Cats just tend to stare at you, don't they? They just sit there and stare at you sometimes until they decide to have a lick or something. But, you know, these foxes, they were just sat there, silent and beautiful. They were ever so beautiful. I mean, this is before we had phone cameras. Well, we did have cameras in our phones, but, you know, we were kind of poor, so... Well, we weren't poor. It's just that back then, phones with cameras were pretty expensive, so we couldn't take pictures of them. I only wish we could have. But these foxes, oh man, they were just so beautiful. And then, around 9 o'clock, about 9 o'clock, it was actually pretty much on the dot. 9 o'clock came, and suddenly they turned and they ran. They ran, and after a few seconds, we could not see them anymore. And me and my father just stared at each other. We just stared at each other and thought, what on earth just happened? What on earth just happened? You know, we'll never know why they were there. Why were they staring at us? So we decided to try and find them, being my father the way he was. I said, no, we'll never find them. Foxes are really, you know, they're really good at hiding. You'll never find them. We might as well just give up and just accept what's happened. But he was adamant. He was very adamant. He really wanted to find these foxes. So what did he do? Yes, eventually I relented and said, okay, fine. Let's go. We might as well just go and find these foxes. So I said to my father, well, Dad, what about the campsite? You've said before that one of us has to stay behind and guard the stuff in case burglars come round and try to rob us. And he said, oh, don't worry, I've got a fantastic idea on how to prevent people from robbing our stuff. And what did he decide to do? Get loads of landmines and plant them all around the campsite. For starters, I asked him, where the hell did you get these? And he said to me, oh no, they're fake. And I said, oh, they're fake? But if they're fake and you bury them, people aren't going to know they're there. But it doesn't matter that nobody knows that they're there, because they're fake. And he said to me, ah, but the thieves are going to watch me plant them and think they're real. See, it's a reverse psychology. If they see me plant them, then they will know that there's landmines, thus preventing them from burgling us. And I said to him, well, what if they come after you've planted the fake landmines? And he said, well, shoot, never mind then. And I said, what do you mean by never mind? And he said, never mind, we'll get our stuff burgled. It'll be worth it to find those foxes. I said, have you lost your mind? We have all our food. And we're like, who knows how far away from home. We'll basically be stranded. And we'll probably be stuck out here for days without any food. And all our stuff will have been robbed. Do you really want that for the sake of a bunch of foxes? And he said, yes. So now let's go. I facepalmed so hard, and I couldn't believe what I was hearing. I said to him, right, in that case, I'm staying here. You can go and hunt your city foxes if you want, but I'm staying right here. And so he agreed, he left, and I just stayed by the campsite. And then the foxes came back. Yep, the foxes came back while my father was gone. I looked at them, they looked at me, And they actually came over to me. Yes, that's right. The foxes, they all sat at my side. And they decided to let me fuss them. I'm not kidding. I had 3 foxes come to me and they let me fuss them. They let me stroke them. They let me rub their tummies. They even let me kiss them on the head. But you don't need to tell anybody that. And so that was it. They stayed with me. But then my father came back and the foxes ran off. Yep, the foxes ran off. And it was that moment I realized they just wanted to sit by me. But they didn't want my father there because they knew he was mad. They could sense his spirit, you see. Because animals, they can sense spirits. And my father is absolutely insane. And his huge amount of insanity was just too much for the poor foxes to handle. But for me, since I, Christopher James, am the most sane person on the planet, they respected me for my composure, for my immense sanity that nobody else has. They loved that. They loved how composed I was, and they knew they could trust me. Trust me with what? I do not know. But then Sunday morning came and I didn't want to leave because I wanted to see these foxes one more time. I never told my father that the foxes came back. In fact, I hope he's never going to watch this video, because if he does, he'll find out they did come back, because I haven't yet told him, by the way. But the fact of the matter is, that's what happened. However, a few years later, I moved out of where I was living. And I moved into my flat. That's right, I moved into the flat I'm living in now. And a few days after, 9 days actually, after I moved into my flat, I went outside, and what was waiting for me outside? One of the three foxes. Yep, that's right. And I knew it was him because this particular fox I remembered the pattern of, and it looked exactly like the one that I saw by the whales. In Wales. It looked exactly like the one I saw in Wales. And now this fox is living with me, and I have named it Ninetales. That's the end of the story. Ninetales is now looking at me, wondering what the heck I'm going on about, and forever he will know that I met him in Wales by a campsite that my father never knew about. Oh, you may be asking, well, if he lives with me, then won't my father see him when he comes to visit me? Well, fortunately for him, my fox can actually be hidden. My fox can actually be hidden in a secret room in my flat that is actually hidden behind the green screen of my living room. Yep, there's a hidden room behind my green screen where the fox is present when my father comes to visit. And that is how I became the Ninetales Commander. Thank you for watching episode 9. Goodbye!